will go through to find out the maximum frequency and minimum frequency, how we will get the maximum frequency and minimum frequency. Okay, let's start about it. That starting the simulation, just it's a very robust tool. Okay, when the simulation starts, okay, just shrink the total value in that particular portion, or you can just put the graph up right there, shrink the value in a certain position. Then just stop the simulation. So that's the part. I can just start and stop. Okay, not like that. Start and start and stop. Oh, stop. Transient. So there's this transient value. If you find out the transient value, that will be the exact value to find out the value where the oscillation starts. You can see that. Again, to find out the starting point, just stop that point. Here you can find out the maximum frequency and minimum frequency. We have to find it out. So how can we get the maximum and minimum frequency? To find out the frequency, we have to change the voltage sign. Just go to the schematic section. And if you want to find out the current, right there you could use the current flow here. Just get through it. In that particular position, we have to remove the voltage probe and start the voltage and current probe right there. So in that particular portion, we have found this voltage and current, and after splitting that, now there is a voltage and current. After simulating the voltage and current, now we can find out the voltage and current here. Both you can see that how much current and voltage flow through to that, and the maximum and minimum current, the current should have to be in the charge. Now here's the current, here's the voltage. So you can find out so there's a spike in the current section, okay, and just start the simulation and check that that's the current, 7.5 milliampere right there, and this is the highest peak value of 5.94 voltage. And the oscillation is starting. Okay, so that is the measurement of the current, the highest peak value, and there is some lowest peak value in the current. Then we will get in the micro ampere range. That is in the lowest peak value. You can see there is a very very, very much lower value, which is 58.915 microampere. So you can theoretically find out, this is theoretical findings, but you can practically find out and make the table again in that particular portion. You get the highest peak value, that is gonna be the 5.944 or 9466 in that particular region. The highest peak value is 7.5 milliampere. So if that is theoretical data, the theoretical data table, so we'll put the data table. It's a theoretical part, almost theoretical part, almost theoretical part, that is. By using the equation right there, we find out the IO, but if you want to find out the value right there, same logic will be there. There are some changes in the current section, that is, if the starting oscillation starts, the current high peak value is 7.5 milliampere. 7.5 milliampere. It means from calculation it's quite high. And the lowest peak value is, just to go to the peak value, that is minus 155.66 microampere. Minus 155.66. That means it's so far beyond that. Okay, so far beyond that. That's 285 microampere. Now it's quite small. But it's 5.94. It is quite larger. There is an experimental value in that particular region. So if you want to find out this kind of things. And there's a comparison between these two values, the theoretical and the practical value. Between these two, you will find that. And that will have to be minus 285 microampere. I'm really, really sorry that I couldn't get the lowest value of that particular region. And 285 millivolt is the negative portion. So you have to get this kind of values right there. So that's gonna be the part. And how can you find out the maximum frequency and minimum frequency? So to find out this, you have to just check the probe. The probes should have to have the voltage and current and all other things to introduce a frequency meter rather than that. Okay. To find the frequency, we have to go to the graphar section. That's the graphar section. Now you can see here the time sections, the transition is right there, and that is in the you have to calculate it from there. That is the highest peak value, goes to the lowest peak value, again highest and lowest. That means that's the total period of time in that particular portion. At that particular portion, in that kind of axis. The value of that axis, we need to know the value of the axis. The value of the axis in that portion is 1.3691 milliseconds. That means the value of t. And if we just inverse it 1 by t, that is the maximum frequency. There is a maximum frequency. Okay. So what will be the minimum frequency? Just go on top of it. That is the starting point. It is 1.3675. 1.3675. Okay. If you just divide it, 1 divided by that, 1 divided by 1.36, as we know, 1 by t, 3675, you will get 0.731. 0.731. That is a milli. So that will be kilo. That will be 100. Just 731.26 hertz. 731.26 hertz. So there is a simple equation. You have to find it out. Just take that value, 1.3675 minus this value.